अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फ्रॉम आकिस फाउंडेशन स्कूल एंड कॉलेज। दिस इज़ मोहम्मद मसूदुल इस्लाम एंड माई इनिशियल इज़ MMI। टुडे आई विल टेक द इंग्लिश ग्रामर क्लास ऑफ क्लास 3, यूनिट 8.2, पेज नंबर 70। लेट्स ओपन द पेज एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज सिंपल पास्ट टेंस। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सिंपल पास्ट टेंस। एट द सेम टाइम वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रेगुलर एंड इरेगुलर वर्ब्स। प्रीवियसली इन आवर रेगुलर क्लासेस वी हैव discussed about simple present tense. So today we will show where is the difference between simple present and simple past tense. So let's see what's the definition of simple past tense. The verb that describes any action happened in the past is called simple past tense. So I'm telling again, the verb that describes any action happened in the past is called simple past tense. And can you recall what was simple present tense? The verb that describes any action happens in the present time is called simple present tense. And whenever this is simple past tense, so the definition will be the verb that describes any action that happened in the past, that is simple past tense structure. Subject plus past form of verb plus extension. And for simple present tense, the structure was subject plus present form of verb plus extension. And for simple past tense, the structure is subject plus past form of verb plus extension. What is the difference? The difference is in the use of verb. In simple present tense, we used present form or base form of verb. And for simple past tense, we are using past form of verb. Okay, let's see some example. I played chess with my sister. Here I have used played. Played, this is the past form of the word play. Whenever I say I played chess with my sister, this is the example of simple past tense. But if I say I play chess with my sister, that is the example of simple present tense. So whenever I am changing the verb, at the same time the tense is also changing. Second example, he opened the window. Opened, this is the past form of open. Number C, we went to school yesterday. Went, this is the past form of go. They did the work together. Did, this is the past form of do. So for simple past tense, we have to use past form of verb. Now we will do some checkpoints. You see in your book, there are 6 sentences. So let's see the first sentence. I saved $50 last month. This is not a correct sentence. Why? The reason is whenever the word last is present in any sentence, at that time the sentence will be simple past tense. And for simple past tense, we have to use past form of verb. Here it is save is used only. Save is the base form of verb. So this is not a correct sentence. The correction will be I saved $50 last month. I am telling the reason again, whenever the word last is present in any sentence, at that time the sentence will be simple past tense. And for simple past tense, we have to use past form of verb. Next, Mrs. Mason teased us this morning. This is not a correct sentence. The reason is the word teased is not a correct word. Actually, for simple past tense, we are using past form of verb, and the past form of the word teach is taught, not teased, taught, T-A-U-G-H-T. This is an irregular verb. So the correct sentence is Mrs. Mason taught us this morning. Next, she cutted the vegetables just now. Cutted, this sentence is not correct also. And cutted word is not correct because the past form of the word cut is cut. That means the base form and past form are same. So the correct sentence will be she cut the vegetables just now. Dear students, now we will do grammar points. Number one. We use the simple past tense to show that an action happened in the past. Already I have discussed this. I am telling again. We use the simple past tense to show that an action happened in the past. Examples: I worked in Melbourne last year. I was in Seoul in 1996. These two events are the events of the past. For this reason, this is the example of simple past tense. Got it? For this reason, I used worked. This is the past form of work, and was, this is the past form of am. So these are the example of simple past tense. Number two, we add ed to regular verbs to form the simple past tense. Irregular verbs take different forms. Okay, there are two lines. I am telling again, we add ed to regular verbs to form the simple past tense, and irregular verbs take different forms. Examples: I cooked spaghetti last night. Cooked, here I have used cooked comes from the word cook. We cook, whenever we add ed at that time, cooked forms. This is regular verb. And the next example, they bought a car last month. Bought, this is the example of an irregular verb. The base form of the word bought is buy, b-u-y, buy means to purchase, and bought, this is the past form, and this is called the irregular verbs. Now you have to remember something. The following are examples of some words that may be used with verbs in the past tense. That means the words that are in blue color here, if you see any of these words in any sentence, at that time you have to make the sentence simple past. And simple past means you have to use the past form of verb. What are the words? The words are just now, last month, 5 years ago, yesterday. If you see any of these words in any sentence, at that time the sentence will be simple past. Anyway, there is last month, not only last month, last day, last week, last year, and after that there is 5 years ago. Not only 5 years ago, but also the number may be changed. 10 years ago, 2 years ago, 15 years ago, just like this. The following are some ways of forming the past tense of regular verbs. So how can we change the regular verbs? Number A, base form of verb plus ed. If we add ed with the base form of verb, then the verb will be, or then we will get past form. For examples, if we add ed with wash, it becomes washed. Then show plus ed, showed. So then washed and showed, these are the examples of past forms, and their present form or base form were wash and show. Number B, base form of verb ending in y. So whenever there is y at the end of any base form, at that time this y will be vanished. In the place of y we will add I, then we will add ed to make it past. For examples, hurry plus ed, y will be vanished, I will be used, then the word will be hurried, h-u-r-r-i-e-d. Marry plus ed, y will be vanished, I will be used, then the word will be married, m-a-r-r-i-e-d. Number C, base form of verb ending in E plus ED. Whenever there is E at the end of any verb at that time, if we want to add ED at that time, we need not to write double E. We will use single E. B-A-T-H-E plus ED is equals to B-A-T-H-E-D. You see very carefully, there is no double E, only single E is used. Next one, advice plus ED, advised. Escape plus ED, escaped. Next, irregular verbs take different forms. You see, there are some irregular verbs, base form and past form are given. Here, no ed is used, just the words are changed. So let's see what are the words. Do, base form do and past form is did. Take, past form is took. Go, past form is went. Catch, past form is caught. Choose, past form is chose. Feel, past form is felt. Draw, past form is drew. Fight, past form is fought. ले पास्ट फॉर्म इज लेड, मीन पास्ट फॉर्म इज मीन्ट, राइट पास्ट फॉर्म इज रोड, सी पास्ट फॉर्म इज सॉ, राइट पास्ट फॉर्म इज रोट। द वर्ब टू बी, देयर आर सम प्रोनाउंस एंड यूज ऑफ एम इज आर वॉज आर विद दिस प्रोनाउंस आर गिवेन हियर। विथ आई वी विल यूज एम इफ द सेंटेंस इज प्रेजेंट टेंस एंड वी विल यूज वॉज इफ द सेंटेंस इज पास्ट टेंस। विथ ही शी और इट वी विल यूज इज इफ द सेंटेंस इज प्रेजेंट एंड वी विल यूज वॉज इफ द सेंटेंस इज पास्ट टेंस। With we, you or they, we will use are if the sentence is present and we will use were if the sentence is past tense. Next, some irregular verbs do not change to form the simple past tense. They keep the base form. For example, the ball hit him on the head just now. The word hit, its base form and past form are same. There are some other words whose words base form and past form are same. The words are beat, cost, cut, hit, hurt, let, put, set, etc. So these irregular verbs do not change the form. Now we will do practice A. It is told to complete the passage by crossing out the wrong verb forms. That means in every part there is two verbs, we will cut the wrong verbs. Okay, let's read. I first see or saw Rita the lioness on a safari in South Africa. Here the word see is crossed, so the correct word is saw. I first saw Rita the lioness on a safari in South Africa. This is the event of past. So the past form is used here. I was or were. I after I we have to use was. So were this is incorrect. I was then in a jeep with three other tourists and a guide. Rina laid or lay quietly in the sun. Here the word laid is incorrect. The word lay is correct. Lay this is the past form of lie. L-I-E lie. So Rina lay quietly in the sun, unaware of our presence. As we come or came nearer, come this is incorrect. So as we came nearer, it will be in past form or simple past form. As we came nearer, she stand or stood. Stand this is the base form, stood this is the past form. So the correct word is stood up. Stood up and there is and. Before and there is a verb, after and there is a verb. So before and after and there are two verbs form will be same. As we used stood before and stood this is the past form, so we have to use past form after and, that is stare or stared. The correct word is stared. So stare this is incorrect, it will be crossed. Stared straight at us. Number 7, I feel or felt. Feel is the base form, felt is the past form. So feel this is incorrect, felt. I felt nervous but everyone else appear or appeared. Which one is past form? Appeared is past form. So we will cross appear and appeared is the correct word. Appeared, come. The other tourists raise or raised. Raise this is base form, raised this is past form. The other tourists raised their cameras to film her. Surprisingly, Rina stretched, this is base form, it is crossed, stretched lazily, and there is another and, after and there is another verb, this verb will be also past form, seem will be crossed, and seemed to pose for the cameras. Now, practice B, change the verbs in bold in the paragraph to the past tense. This is very easy. We have to change the verb into past. Just we will make the changes. Okay, let's read. My brother and I are at Uncle Ben's farm for a week. In the morning, Aunt Dora fries eggs and makes porridge. for us. After breakfast, we help Uncle Ben. We collect the hen's eggs. We put them in egg trays and leave them in the kitchen. Then we feed all the animals and sweep the farmyard. At about 10 a.m., we take a rest under the trees. Then we clean the fish pond. This is the paragraph. We will change the verbs into past. So number one, there is are, it will be where. Number two, fries, it will be fried. Number three, makes, it will be made. Number four, help, it will be helped. Number five, collect, it will be collected. Number six, put, it will be put, because its present base form and past form are same. Number seven, leave, it will be left. Number eight, feed, it will be fed, F-E-D. Number nine, sweep, it will be swept, S-W-E-P-T. Number 10, take, it will be took. Number 11, clean, it will be cleaned. Dear students, please make a correction. Now practice C. Fill in the blanks with the present tense or past tense form of the verbs in the brackets. In bracket you will see there is a verb. We have to use either the present tense or the past tense. Okay, number one, Lisa dashed her room yesterday. In bracket the verb is paint. As the word yesterday is present in the sentence, so yesterday means it's happenings of the past time. For this reason the sentence will be simple past tense, so we have to use the past form of the word paint. So it will be painted. Lisa painted her room yesterday. Number two, I wash my clothes and dash them in the morning. I wash my clothes and. There is and before and there is the verb wash, and after and there will be another verb. And here wash is in base form. So after and dry base form will be used. Number three, the hungry baby dashed up at 4 a.m. this morning. This morning, that means the work is already done. So the hungry baby dashed up. There is the verb wake. So we have to use oak. Past form of the verb wake is oak. W-O-K-E. Next. Last Saturday, a thief dashed Lily's handbag from her car. And the verb is steal. Last Saturday, that means it's a happening of past time. For this reason, the sentence will be simple past tense. So we have to use the past form of the word steal. And the past form of the word steal is stole. S-T-O-L-E. Stole. Number five, Rico dash cakes for her family every week. Every week, he or she does this. That means it's a habitual work. So the word here is bake. So we have to use the present form or base form of the word bake. And Rico, this is the third person singular number. For this reason we have to add S or ES with the verb. Bakes, it will be bakes. I used here S. The reason is Rico, the subject, is third person singular number. And this is the example of simple present tense. In simple present tense, there is a condition. The condition is if the subject is third person singular number, at that time we have to add S or ES with the verb. Number six, I dash the rackets and John has the tennis ball. Look here very carefully. I dash the rackets and John has the tennis ball. Here, there is and before and there is a gap, I dash. And after and there is a verb, that is has. So has, this is in base form or present form. So first verb, it will be in base form also. After I, we have to use have. I have. Number seven, we dash chase last weekend. Last, the word last means the happenings of past time. For this season it will be simple past tense. So we have to use the past form of the word play. Then it will be played. वी प्लेड चेस लास्ट वीकेंड नंबर 8 दे डैश इन यूरोप 2 वीक्स एगो 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 मीन्स ऑल्सो सेम हैपनिंग्स ऑफ पास्ट टाइम फॉर दिस सीजन द सेंटेंस विल बी ऑल्सो सिंपल पास्ट टेंस सो वी हैव टू यूज द पास्ट फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ड बी हियर कीप इन माइंड दैट फ्रॉम बी वी कैन राइट एम इज आर बोथ बी एंड एम इज आर दिस फोर वर्ड्स आर द बेस फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ड verb and past form of the these verbs are was or were. After they we have to use were because they is third person plural number. Number 9, the pupils this is also plural dash at the factory an hour ago. Ago there is ago for this season it will be again simple past tense arrived. The pupils arrived at the factory an hour ago. Number 10, she dashed her hand just now. So just now the whenever just now is present in the sentence then we have to make it simple past tense heart. The word heart its base form is heart and its past form is also heart. She hurt her hand just now. Number 11, he dashed his work for 2 hours every night. Every night he does this is a habitual work. For this season we have to use a simple present tense and the verb here is revise and the subject is he. He is a third person singular number. For this season we have to add s or es with the word revise. It will be revises, s will be added. The reason is he is the third person singular number and this is the example of simple present tense. Whenever the subject is simple present tense at that time we have to whenever the subject is third person singular number and the tense is simple present tense at that time we have to add s or es with the verb. Now practice D. Complete the sentences with the correct verb forms of the words in the box. So, what are the verbs here? Be, call, come, gaze, hurry, lead, make, peep, prevent, remove, see. There are 11 words total. Now we have to complete the sentences with this verb. Rick dashed about to fall asleep when suddenly an unusual sound outside dashed him jump up. He dashed from behind the curtain and dashed two men on a ladder. The ladder dashed to the window of the attic. Rick dashed, they were burglars. Okay, this is the first half of the paragraph. We will complete this at first. After that, we will go to the next paragraph. Rick dashed about to fall asleep. Rick was. We got was from the word be. From the word be, we can write am or is or are. Then was or were. Then also be also. So number 1, Rick was about to fall asleep when suddenly an unusual sound outside made him jump up. He dashed from behind. He peeped from behind the curtains and saw two men on a ladder. The ladder led from lead. The past form of lead is led. Led to the window of the attic. Rick guessed they were burglars. He quickly dashed the police. Then he dashed upstairs and locked the door of the attic. After that, he quietly stepped out of the house and dashed the ladder. In that way, he dashed the burglars from escaping. The police dashed soon after and took them away. So, he quickly called the police. Then he hurried upstairs and locked the door of the attic. After that, he quietly stepped out of the house and removed the ladder. In that way, he prevented the burglars from escaping. The police dash came soon after he took them away. Now practice E. In each sentence, a mistake in verb form has been underlined. Write the correct form of the verb in the box. Number 1, Wendy birthed the baby now, so she cannot answer phone. Now, whenever there is now in any sentence, at that time we have to make it प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस मीन्स आफ्टर सब्जेक्ट वी हैव टू ऐड एम और इज और आर एनी वन. आफ्टर दैट बेस फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब प्लस आई एन जी प्लस एक्सटेंशन. सो इट विल बी वेंडी इज बाथिंग द बेबी नाउ सो शी कैन नॉट आंसर द फोन. दिस इज द करेक्शन. नंबर टू, we find our front door unlocked when we came home last Sunday. And the last part of the sentence is in past form, so we will make the first verb into past. We found our front door unlocked when we came home last Sunday. Number three, the shoes cost too much so I cannot afford them. Shoes, this is not singular, this is plural, so after plural subject we cannot use singular verb. Singular verb means whenever s or es is there with the verb, at that time the verb is singular. So the correct sentence is the shoes cost too much so I cannot afford them. Number four, our neighbors bring us a bag of tomatoes yesterday. So there is yesterday, so it will be in simple past tense. We have to use brought. Our neighbors brought us a bag of tomatoes yesterday. Number five, Scott do his work neatly and accurately. Scott, this is the name of any person, and this is the third person singular number. After third person singular number, we have to use, if we use base form of verb, we have to add s or es with the verb. Scott does his work neatly and accurately. And if we say Scott did his work neatly and cleanly, this sentence is also correct. So we can make either simple present tense or simple past tense, no problem at all. Number six, Kevin think that we were not at home because nobody answered the doorbell. It will be simple past tense. Kevin thought that. And we can also write Kevin thinks, because Kevin is the third person singular number, so after Kevin we can use base form of verb and s or es with that verb. Number seven, Dad let us stay up late yesterday because it is a holiday today. Late is not a correct word. The past form of the word late is also late. So Dad let us stay up late yesterday because it is a holiday today. Number 8. Diana burned her hand when she tried to light the stove. So the past form of the word burn is burnt. The sentence will be Diana burned her hand when she tried to light the stove. Number 9. Aunt Celine scolded me for spilling tea on her carpet. Scolded me, this is not correct. It will be scolded me for spilling tea on her carpet. Number 10. These days we usually went out for dinner on Saturdays. These days we usually went. We usually, the word, whenever the word usually is present, it means it will be simple present tense. We usually go out for dinner on Saturdays. Now practice F. Fill in the blanks with the simple present or simple past tense form of the words in the brackets. There are total 11 gaps. First one is done for you. Judy. Judy goes. It will be goes because Judy, it's a name of a person and the sentence is in simple present tense. And Judy, as this is the third person singular number, so extra as s or es will be added with the verb. Then go plus es equals to goes. Goes for a walk in the park at about 6 a.m. every morning. Her husband Ted usually accompanies. Her husband Ted usually. Whenever usually is present in any sentence, at that time this will be simple present tense. And Ted, it is also third person singular number. So after third person singular number, for simple present tense, we will add s or es with the verb. Then it will be accompanies. Accompanies her. But today he remained at home. Today he remained at home. He dash a bad cold. He had, this is past simple past tense, he had a bad cold and needed to rest. I used here had because there after cold there is and after and there is another verb that is needed. Needed is the past form. Needed is in past form. So before and, the word have, it will be in past form, that will is had. Then number 5, Judy dash off by herself. Set off. Set, present form and past form are same. Moments later, she dashed that someone was following her. She realized that someone was falling. Was falling, this is in past form. So she realized that someone was following her. Number 7, she dashed extremely frightened. She felt, it will be in simple past tense or past form. She felt extremely frightened. She quickly dashed for the main road. She quickly headed for the main road where there were more people. Judy dash, number 9, Judy dash ran all the way home. The run, it will be ran, this is the past form of the word run. Number 10, she dashed fling open the door and shouted for Ted. She flung open the door and shouted for Ted. And 11 number, he dashed running down. He came running down the stairs to find out what was wrong. Okay. Okay, these are the answers. This is the end of today's class. Thank you for being with us.